Tesla has finally begun mass production at their GigaFactory in Austin, better known as Giga Texas. This GigaFactory is set to be one of the most significant production facilities of any car in the world. Which Tesla models will be produced at Giga Texas? How many cars can this factory produce? And what was the cost to build it? In today's video, we will be telling you everything about it, so stick around to the end to find out more. Tesla made a company record in 2021 when they successfully managed to produce over 900,000 units of their models. As of 2022, Elon Musk, the CEO of Tesla, decided not to release any new models this year, as he said that the company is aiming to increase the number of models they produce every year and introducing newer models like the Cybertruck, Semi, or the rumored $25,000 Tesla would slow down that process drastically. In January 2022, Tesla said that it began producing vehicles at its $1.1 billion Travis County production plant in the last few months of 2021. Builds of Model Ys started in late 2021 at GigaFactory Texas. After final certification of Austin-made Model Y, we plan to start deliveries to customers, Tesla management said in their fourth quarter earnings report. Tesla, which announced in October that it was relocating its corporate headquarters to Austin, also stated that its Model Y vehicles are undergoing equipment testing in both Texas and Berlin. Model Y is expected to be a crucial product for the business. Since Elon Musk announced in July 2020 that he had chosen the Southwest Travis County location for the project, which the company has called Giga Texas, construction of the complex has progressed rapidly. Tesla has announced that it will manufacture its Cybertruck, Semi, Model 3 compact sedan, and Model Y vehicles in Travis County. According to Musk, the facility may eventually employ 10,000 people. Tesla claimed in its earnings report that manufacturing in Austin would pick up on the coming days, and that work on the Cybertruck is still progressing and will now possibly be delayed till the last quarter of 2022 or the first quarter of 2023. Musk also revealed in January that he's been driving a Cybertruck all around the Austin facility via a tweet on Twitter. Industry watchers assumed the Austin area facility was nearing or had already started production after company executives hinted that it would start before the end of 2021. Musk also announced in December 2021 that the factory would hold a grand opening party in early 2022, complete with factory tours. Musk predicted 2021 would be a breakthrough year for Tesla during a conference call with investors and analysts. He stated that the company's current focus would be on its two newest plants. Musk said, "After an exceptional year, we shift our focus to the future, Texas and Berlin," Musk said. It is worth noting that we, as the internet has observed, have been making quite a few cars in Texas. The company's Austin facility is intended to be the hub of its operations and production. According to industry analyst Dan Ives of Wedbush Securities, Tesla's Austin area facility will be the heart of Tesla's production for the next few years. Launching the Austin manufacturing is critical for Tesla to grow both domestic and global Model Y production, which is expected to have a record year in 2022, Ives added. This reason was because of the exponential growth in numbers that Tesla has witnessed in the past 3 years. Their production has increased by over 300% since 2018, and they plan on maintaining these numbers as the market demand for EVs increases. Tesla reported a profit of $5.5 billion in 2021. This is the third year in a row that Tesla has been profitable. The company's recorded $17.72 billion in revenue, which was also significantly higher than expected, selling regulatory credits to other manufacturers to meet government emissions regulations generated $314 million in revenue. The company stated, "There should no longer be any doubt about the viability and profitability of electric vehicles." Along with Giga Berlin, Austin is expected to play a crucial role in growing Tesla's production. Ives estimated that the Austin area facility would start producing cars in early February and build up to full capacity by the final quarter of 2022 or early 2023. Model Ys currently being produced in Texas have a structural battery pack, Musk said, and deliveries would begin following final certification, which he expects to happen fairly soon. However, once these are delivered, any cars made in Austin will have to be sent out of state before being sold to Texans, at least for the time being. Currently, automobile manufacturers are forbidden by state law from selling directly to consumers, as Tesla does. Musk mentioned that the Austin area plant has office space, with some of those offices overlooking the assembly line, though he did not specify whether or not they are the headquarters offices. Musk also said, "While we battled, and everyone did, with supply chain challenges throughout the year, we managed to grow our volume by nearly 90% last year. This level of growth didn't happen by coincidence. It was a result of ingenuity and hard work across multiple teams throughout the company." Now, before we tell you whether or not the GigaFactory in Texas is expected to produce higher numbers this year, we would firstly like to thank you for making it to here. And we would really appreciate it if you could show your support to our channel by liking this video and subscribing to Elon Musk Facts. Having said that, let's continue. Although supply chain challenges are expected to persist, Musk said on a conference call with investors that Tesla still predicts a 50% growth in the coming year. Tesla's non-vehicle items will also receive attention. Musk stated that Optimus, a humanoid robot product known as a Tesla bot, will focus on the business in the coming year, though it is unclear whether they will be manufactured in Austin. The bot's initial application, according to Musk, will be in factories, moving parts around, or performing other similar jobs, and it will be ready for production next year. He went on to say that the bot business has the ability to overtake Tesla's vehicle industry in the long run, and that it may help relieve future labor shortages. Musk also stated that the company's full self-driving software, which is now being tested, will be a profit generator in the future. Executives at the company said they're comfortable with what they see in Texas and want to use it as a model as they expand to new states this year. According to Amber Gunst, the CEO of the Austin Technology Council, the facility's startup is exciting. "It's something that we've all been watching," Gunst said. "The factory is going up, and we've been anticipating people being able to start working there and start building and having vehicles hit the road. So we're just really excited to see this project move forward and this company being here and offering great quality jobs to Central Texas." The start of production comes with Austin becoming a more important hub for Tesla. Musk said in October that Tesla would relocate its corporate headquarters from California to Austin, though he provided few details at the time. The company legally relocated its corporate headquarters to the same site as the factory, according to records filed with the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission in December. Texas, particularly Austin, is becoming increasingly crucial to Musk. The billionaire claimed that he relocated to Texas in 2020 to be closer to the Gigafactory and